Sometimes when you film, your shots don't look as good as you imagined. The lighting may be horrendous, the colors may look too washed out, and you might not be able to see a thing in the final clip. If you struggle with these things or any variation of them, then this video is for you. Today, we will be showing you how to fix the settings on your camera in Premiere Pro to ensure that your shots look as good as possible.
When fixing the white balance in Premiere, first select your clip. We'll use this clip of Brady. As you can see here, the environment around him looks very yellow, and it's causing his skin to have more of a yellow tone, which does not help his shiny forehead here. To fix this yellow tone, select the eyedropper tool and the side under white balance. You'll need to find somewhere white to click on. Realistically, we could use his forehead sheen, but to spare his dignity, we'll select the white from his shirt. As you can see, everything looks much less yellow and more natural. Now, he still looks reflective, sure, but we'll talk about how to fix those problems later.
On the camera in pre-production, you can fix the white balance by going to exposure mode and clicking S. You can also adjust exposure by using the knob on the top of the camera.
We'll be using this clip to demonstrate how to adjust colors in Premiere. This hallway has very yellow lighting for some reason, so it's a perfect environment for bad colors. It somehow manages to make everyone look yellow and washed out at the same time. To combat this, go to the side and look for the eyedropper again. You'll want to find any changes in the white balance first, and as you can see, there's no changes. Now, you'll want to go under the eyedropper and find these bars. Adjusting the temperature can make the clip have more of a blue tone or more of an orange tone. We're already yellow enough, so we'll make the temperature cooler. Next, the tint. This can either make the clip more green-toned or more pink-toned. We don't want to make this too green, so we'll bring it to the left just a bit. Finally, the saturation. This will make the clip more monotone or more vibrant. We don't want the clip to look dead, but we don't want it to be obnoxiously bright, so we'll bring down the saturation just a bit. Now, you can see that the clip looks much better and much less in-your-face yellow. To demonstrate how to fix light exposure, we'll use this clip of Ryan. As you can see, overall it is a very dark clip and the shadows are very pronounced. In order to fix this, we're gonna go over to the side where we've used everything else so far, and we're gonna find the light area. When it comes to exposure, you can see that this shows you how much light will be added in or taken out of the clip. We are going to bring it up just a bit. When it comes to contrast, bringing it all the way to the right will make it very noticeably dark, but bringing it all the way to the right will make it look super washed out and pale. When it comes to highlights, I'm sure you can guess that deals with, well, the highlights. Bringing it all the way to the right will make the lights very prominent, and then bringing it down will cause them to look less in-your-face bright. With the shadows, bringing it all the way to the left will make it super dark, and then bringing it all the way to the right will lighten it up. With the whites, as you can see, if we bring it down all the way, it makes it super dark. But if we bring it up, then that'll make it really bright and pale. And with the blacks, that deals with all of the shadows once again. So we don't want to make that too dark, so we are going to bring it down just a little, and as you can see, it looks so much better than before.
When you go to the menu, go up to exposure mode, and you can also select it as S. A way to adjust what the light looks like as well is going to photo style. Clicking on that will bring you to a menu of a bunch of different things that you can do to adjust the camera settings. One of the things that I like to use is contrast, as it displays a difference of the light settings in the camera shot in general. You can also adjust noise reduction, which makes the image less blurry, and saturation, which does what it sounds like. Hopefully after watching this, you now have a better idea about how to adjust camera settings on pre-production and post-production.